I'll be honest with you. Yeah, simple Simon here. I'll be honest with you. Women, black women in particular, they get a lot of stress, man. Black women get run through the mill on a lot of stuff. If it's not hair, if it's not big bottom, if it's not breasts, if it's not, you know, like, there's always something.
What do you mean run through the mill?
As in, can they cook? What's their hair like? Do they wear makeup?
They get critiqued more than any other race and gender.
A black woman gets critiqued more than any other human being.
Is that because
always critiqued by themselves and by others as well?
By themselves.
Is that because we expect more from them?
It's partly that.
Yes.
Sorry, is it we as black men or we as society?
We as black men.
I
think black men blatantly expect more from black women than they do from any other women. In a strange way, whilst putting them down at the same time.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and dogs, rodents and other small insects, welcome to another episode of Eloquently Saying Nothing. This is season 2, episode number 2. I'm Stavros Boss. Let's see who else we have in the room.
It is I, the one from Africa. Simple Simon is in the building.
Finally, the wolf has come back. It's episode 2, season 2, baby.
You sound like you're going to say what The Rock is cooking or something.
Yeah, that's The Rock, baby. The Rock, man. We're talking WWE.
What's going on, people? It's 2 of 2. What's your girl going to do? It's your boy, Black Parker.
I never ever get any of your intros, bro. What's 2 of 2? Explain it. Wallace, by the way, is Wallace.
It's episode 2.
Oh,
season 2.
Why, I get it now.
Today, bro. It's slow today.
I was slow, man. No worries. Wallace in the building, as always, and fat as always. What's going on?
We have Mr. Kipling apple pies here.
On the table. And I'm looking at them with such eyes, but I'm not allowed to touch.
Why not?
They're too to touch. Because I'm trying to cut down on the sweet stuff, you know?
Okay. You just had a Jaffa cake, bruv.
Yeah, that's not a Mr. Kipling apple pie, is it?
It's just too sweet.
No, it's not. A one Jaffa cake doesn't equal the same calories as a Mr. Kipling apple pie, though, is it?
Why are you watching the calories now?
Because
right now, looking at you now, you're still watching calories.
But do you even know how backwards what you're talking is? So I should watch it when I'm skinny.
You say you don't want to eat it because you're fat, but then you had a Jaffa cake, but you're not equating the amount of calories, and you had a scone.
Just
admit
you messed up. Just admit I messed up. I don't know what I'm talking about now.
Yes, you did.
No, I could have messed up by telling you that I don't want to eat a Mr. Kipling apple pie because of the calories, and you're comparing.
But then you had a scone.
Yeah,
and a Jaffa cake.
Yes, and then do I want to add extra the apple pie as well?
You might as well
one
keep going.
One extra apple pie won't make
it. It makes a difference.
It's not going to make a difference.
If you've got a certain amount of calories that you're supposed to have in a day,
how much have you had today?
I have no idea. But let's be honest, it'll make a difference.
Start counting now, though.
Listen, you want me to die anyway. I've known this already. You're going to go before me, so don't worry about it. That's how fat people stay fat. People just want to be the enablers. Nigerians are proper enablers, you know. Nigerians are the worst enablers on the planet.
You could be in a hospital. Oh, yeah, it's now.
You could be in a hospital for diabetes, whatever it is. They'll come with glucose. Yeah, take.
It will make you feel better.
Bloody enablers,
man. Okay, yeah. Nobody's going to die.
You never know.
All right. Where are we? Okay. What's the first thing we're going to talk about? All right, last week we didn't get to this topic. We didn't get to it. We ran out of time. This LGBT community. Is LGBTQ.
Yeah, you got to put the Q on the end.
LGBTQ.
No, for the people that don't know what that is, could you please explain, Stavros?
The L stands for lesbian. G stands for gay.
Which you are.
B stands for bisexual.
Which you are.
T stands for transsexual.
Which you are.
And Q stands for queer?
Which you definitely are.
Okay, so what's the difference between the gay and the queer bit?
This is... No, it's a good question, because when I first found out about it, Simple Simon, I asked exactly the same question. And I guess what I was told is that you can be queer and you don't have to be homosexual or gay.
So so in other words, you could be a bit... Queer, are we going by the definition that queer is a bit weirdish?
I'm guessing.
So transsexual is not weirdish anymore.
transsexual. Gay,
you know what I mean? So, so I don't understand. So, what are you? What is the weird part of the? What is the? Where's the queer bit?
Do you know the funny thing about queer? Queer is a characteristic. Whereas, whether if you're transsexual, you're physically different.
No, because some okay. When you do trans, when you're transsexual, does that mean that you have had to actually have had the operation to go from man to woman,
or well, there's not the full one. Post-op in it?
Yeah,
yeah. So then, for me, I'm trying to understand it because obviously we're from an era where queer meant gay.
Yes, in a way. I was going to say exactly the same thing. Or I'm from an era where queer was gay, a euphemism for gay,
or even what's the one that they that the gays that even some of the gays hate?
What do they call
it? No, not the faggots. Not call them faggots. Camp. That's it.
No. Gay people don't hate camp people.
Yes, they do. A lot of gay people don't like camp people.
Okay, so that... So, what's his name?
For what I know.
What was his name? The guy that did the high kicking thing. What's his name?
Louis Spence.
Is he... Would he be camp?
He's camp.
No, there's but... Okay, again, to be, okay,
not, let me not, just say, let me not say camp, yeah? But I've... This is...
Because you don't have to be gay to be camp.
Exactly. That's the thing. But, okay, this is what I've heard this in some of the... discussions I've heard about with homosexuals, so I can't really say that I'm a master of it, but I've heard that a lot of homosexuals are not necessarily that welcoming to gay men that behave in a what they will call a womanly fashion, because they think that that's taken away from, you know, going over the top, behaving in a womanly fashion type way.
The actual definition for queer is actually strange and odd.
Yeah, so I don't understand why. Yeah. But what's that got to do with your sexuality? I don't get what that has to then do with your sexuality. Even though transsexual is not necessarily your sexuality.
I think
either.
It's a back in the day term for gay people.
Whereas, yeah, but then why is it added on top now? Why can't you just have the queer was an insult to gay people? They was using it as an insult.
Yeah, like you're strange.
So then why do they want to add that onto the end? To me, I don't understand what they're championing with that. I don't get it.
But sorry about the thing you were saying about camp as well earlier on. Like, I work with a lot of gay people. And they call, which is, this will surprise me, they call like the Louis Spence types faggots.
Yeah, because as I said, they don't necessarily, from what I know, there's a lot of gay, well, let me not say a lot because I can't tell you a lot, but I know that there's a few gay people that don't like the gay, out like the gay men that are outlandish, behaving like a woman.
Yeah, that not, extrovert.
Not masculine in the way that there are men. Like there's men that obviously are just act like men and they're just gay.
Yeah.
And there's men that, want to still be men but act like women
and get really eccentric and stuff like
and
that
and are gay.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
There's men that's that act like that are not even gay and act like women like stuff that do that all the time.
So what are you saying that
clearly it's my week to get it to this.
It's all good. Bring it on.
Nah, I'm joking.
That homosexuals call the Louis Spence type faggots.
I can only speak. I can only speak for the ones that I have met and I've worked with,
and they're.
Apparently,
okay,
you know,
with that term. I'm assuming that the word
again, this is the thing.
I think the F word is the new N word.
Oh, possibly.
So that's what I've been told. The F word is the new N word.
What does that mean exactly?
So as in, it's back. It's not something that you, no. As in, you can't just fling it out there without some sort of repercussion.
So they like it can't be used as a term of endearment.
As in, as a black person, you may use the N word and get away with it, but you could use the word gay. Or you could use the word queer. If you use the F word and you're not gay, then it's an issue.
But if you are gay, then some will say then it's okay.
Some and some wouldn't. Same as the N word. Same as I don't like the N word. I don't think it should be used. But if another black man said it, you're not necessarily going to pick up a hammer and lock him on the head. Whereas if a white man said it, you might do that. And that's like the equivalent now to a gay person. Another gay person might use the word. You might say, you shouldn't use that word. It's not a nice word.
Fair enough.
But if a straight person uses it, you might give him a backhand.
But real talk,
your handbag.
What was the actual question? What was the actual question?
The question was, well, this is something that one of the panel has brought up. They think, or they feel, that there's some sort of overrunning on the social media by the LGBTQ community. It seems like they're running things on social media now. They are the leaders and controls and controllers.
And the black community. I think they're Jewish. The black community as well.
Are all gays Jews?
Well,
no. I think the Jews
run everything.
I think it's a more culture. I'm not talking about the corporations and such. I'm talking about the actual where things shift to, like the trends and such. It was Wahala that asked the question or brought up this thing, by the way. And it wasn't just the LGBT. I don't even remember what the LGBTCT.
London Community Gospel Choir.
LGBTQ.
Okay, so you said that for me. And than I reckon the black community, because they've got this thing called Black Twitter, that they talk about Black Twitter, and how powerful Black Twitter is. And also, I think that the
LGBTQ-LMNOP.
I'm going to get this right for once.
LGBTQ.
I'm not saying the Q. LGBT community, I think are also quite a force on Twitter and other types of social media. Like a lot of what they think is acceptable or what they think should be allowed is what becomes like the major things, especially on Twitter. I use Twitter often. Not too often. I started to use Twitter a lot more now, but I've noticed a lot of Black Twitter and the LGBT community are quite a force on Twitter. Like, they're quite a force. They make a lot of the hashtags. The Black Lives Matter started off from obviously black people, and a large part of it is from the LGBT community. Am I wrong in saying that?
The leader is two women, I believe, if I remember correctly, started off Black Lives Matter, and they were gay.
And a guy. No, the one of the main spokesmen.
No, he is a spearhead of the movement. Okay, but he didn't start the movement.
Okay, and he's also gay.
So because you're gay or lesbian, does that automatically make you a member of the LGBT community?
Of course it does.
I would say so.
Because the same way that if you're black, it automatically makes you a part of the black community.
Stacey Dash.
She's also part of the black community.
Raven Simone.
A black community.
Lil Wayne.
What's wrong with
you? All of them said that they're not black. They don't see themselves as
whether
black.
Whether or not they see themselves as black or not, they're still part of the black community, isn't it?
No, I don't know.
Whether or not you want to accept them, there's many communities where people you don't want to accept. There's certain people that eat Ghanaian angel off. I have to accept them in the black community. As much as I want to throw them out, as much as I think they're a disgrace, I have to accept them in the black community because they're black. The same way that there's certain other people, murderers, killers, whatever, you don't want to necessarily walk with them down the street, but they're black, so they're part of the black community. That's just how it is. The same way that if you're gay, or you're lesbian, straight or you're transsexual, away, you're already part of that community.
You might not
move with that community. Yeah, you might not be heavily involved in their activities,
yeah.
But you're part of the community, isn't it?
I hear what you're saying. But I would say that the LGBT community moves things more in court, legally, and yes, the black community does more in the way of trends on social media and stuff like that. And the reason why I say that is because as much as there's all this stuff going on with the Black Lives Matter movements and all the rest of it, you don't see any laws or legal precedents being taken by any of that action. Whereas with the LGBT community, they move stuff. Like, once upon a time, a gay person couldn't get married. Now gay people can get married. And it's like sanctioned in church and stuff that couldn't happen before. I don't see the same legal triumph from the black community as I do with the LGBT
community. That black community was in the 50s and 60s.
What, that legal stuff?
Mm. Yeah, but we're talking about on the social media.
I'm talking about on the social media scale now. So I'm talking about as of today, LGBT community for me move more things legally than maybe they do socially, and I think as far as trends are concerned, and maybe I'm talking about issues that are not like serious issues. I'm talking about actual trends, as in this community got this thing trending. I see that black people, as far as popular culture and that's concerned, get things trending. Yes, definitely. But I don't know about the LGBT community in the same light.
Is that because the black community gets shut down, or because you feel they're not trying hard enough?
I feel like it's where your energies are focused as well. Yeah, so there's a little bit of being shut down, but there's also where your energies are focused as well. And it's about how the direction of what your causes are about are being put. So the black movements, I tend to find that they understand, or we, if you like, understand that you need numbers to do stuff. And so we get the numbers by making the thing popular. But then we don't extend those numbers into legal precedents. We don't put that to a case to say, yes, let's have this thrown out in front of a judge and let them have a look at this for what it is, and in a legal aspect.
I think in relation to a lot of the unarmed killings in America and, you know, the injustices, and I say injustices because they have been taken to court and they've just been shut down.
This is what happens. They go to court for like this, like police brutality and stuff like that. Because this is a good point you made up. Do you remember the video that was circulating of the kids that were at a pool party?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the police officer body slammed one of the children onto the ground. Okay.
He did that California roll.
With that case now, that police officer was suspended from work or what have you. And I just read today that the family is taking the police and the city to court. And they're suing them for $5 million. Now, what will tend to happen in that case is they will be paid out, and in paying them out, it's a settlement, which means that nobody actually accepts law or fault or liability, and therefore no laws change. So what happens is, on a micro scale, that family's life is changed, because it's now there was no $5 million and now there's $5 million, but it doesn't extend to the greater black community. It means that every single black family that has a legal battle has to go through an individual legal battle in order to win or lose. So not every family is going to get paid out. Some will, some won't. The amount will change and what have you and what have you. So it means that there isn't a massive gross gain. It's a net gain, where it's like just one family is gaining. So with that, I'm saying, with an LGBT community, similar thing would happen, and they would band together in a way that says, this is not allowed to happen to anybody from the LGBT community again.
For the love of money.
Yeah. And it will happen with any other community. That's what they would do. They would make it a precedent to say, this should never happen again. So whereas
you're basically saying blacks are weak.
No, I'm saying we're not organized in the same way in the same hemisphere. That's what I'm saying.
I don't think it's a case of organization. I think I'm going to touch on what Yemi was saying. I think it's a case of that we just get shut down. Done. We try to do this, we try to do movements, and then at times we just get shut down. Why the LGBT community doesn't get shut down is probably because a lot of the people that's actually involved in some of the lawmaking are actually maybe either undercover gay or openly gay, and they are going to understand, have a more, you know, of a understanding to that community. Whereas with the lawmakers and the people that make, or you're going to call them society or whatever you want to call them, the institution, a lot of them are probably not black.
Yeah, but so then you say that, but then there's a, what city is it? It's gonna evade me now. But there's a city where there's a whole bunch of black women that are either judges or attorney generals,
and they all report to somebody that's what, probably.
Yeah, I hear that.
And they can't actually change laws. You're a judge. A judge can't change laws, you know.
Yeah, I hear that.
The Constitution needs to change laws. So again, if they're not necessarily going to have that same feeling.
We've gone back to the system again.
Yeah, so I'm saying it's the system. I agree with you, what you're saying, though, with regards to the black movements. And this is going to touch on what I think Mr. Wolf wanted to talk about beforehand, which was regarding the way that we set, like a lot of the trends that we set are stuff like all the viral videos. A lot of them are started from black people. Like,
oh, yeah, of course.
Like, definitely black social media and black Twitter.
These challenges, all these challenges. Yes, yeah, so
all this
most
stuff like
them,
the mannequin challenges, either from black Instagram, black Twitter, but all of this comes from black people. The origins usually start from one black person or a group of black people that's done something.
So do you think it's a case of acceptance? Because especially with the LGTB,
LBG,
yeah.
The acronyms.
Them lot. They're more accepted than in the community than black people.
I think
everyone's more accepted than black people.
Yeah, than black
people. Let's just be honest.
I think even
dogs are more acceptable than black people. Let's be honest.
And Irish.
I think, to be honest, and I even think, to be honest,
100%.
Okay, I'm gonna throw this out there, but I think actually in this day and age, black, especially male gays, are probably more accepted than black male straight.
Black male straight.
In certain areas now, because I
black male gays are probably more accepted than black straight females.
Yeah, I'm saying in general. I'm just saying that they're probably higher now on the ladder than actually straight male and females, blacks.
Well, that's a question.
I'm not saying necessarily in the black community, but I'm saying outside of the black community, I think they're probably more
acceptable. Maybe they're seen as safe, maybe.
Maybe they're seen as safe.
Because I guess an issue with black people is that we're seen as threatening to people that aren't black. And maybe gay people are just seen as less threatening.
Or,
rightly or wrongly.
Or maybe they just see them as part of their community. Because they're now part of this LGBT community. And it no longer puts them in the black community in the same level as the LGBT.
Well,
so they're taking them. Hold on. Let me just finish. Because I'm assuming that they're being the LGBT community are now saying you're being oppressed by your own people because black people don't like you as gays.
So we're
going to accept you into our LGBT. You know, don't worry about the blacks. It touches on what we were talking about last week with the whole tips that they say is, you know, the whole deep people, which as well, because they're not people, it's a word, but they call them a people, where they say they're misogynistic and they're very anti-gay. So there's a lot of black inter beefing between the communities, because a lot of new age black people in the black community, especially in America, are very open and are more willing to deal with, you know, homosexuality as an open thing. They're willing to
okay,
so,
okay.
Wait,
okay,
wait,
okay.
Let me make it more easier for our listeners to understand. So in society and in the community, black stav is not accepted. But if we take black stav out of the society and community and put him into LGBTQ, he's more accepted.
He's not gay, so no.
Let's imagine he is.
He's the only one married here with woman, which doesn't really make a difference these days in the way that gay
it doesn't. Listen, Barrymore shocked the hell out of me, man.
Let's go back to, you know, what I'm saying. But I think at the moment,
I want to drop some irony here. Yeah.
Yeah, go on.
So this whole thing that you're saying about the acceptance of gay people in particular and the black community not accepting gay people in particular is really funny, because it actually stems from religion. The religion that the same white people have been pushing
exactly
from day. So it's really weird.
Touching on that, the situation with Ellen DeGeneres.
Or DeGeneres.
Don't worry about what I said before. It's what I'm saying now. And Kim Burrell. So Kim Burrell's a preacher.
Yes.
Gospel singer.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
And she was caught on stage making some comments.
You put on a bit.
About homosexuals, how they curse people, or they have sinners. Spirits. They're sinners, and basically,
they got a spirit, a particular spirit inside them that makes them like that.
And are they going, they can't get to heaven or something like that? Would it?
I'm not sure she said they can't get to heaven, but she's saying that basically they've got this spirit inside them and they need to be released of this spirit.
She also said that we're all sinners and that that is just another sin.
But she said it's perverted. And I think that's the word that people were getting very agitated about, the fact that she kept on calling it a perverted spirit. It's a sinful spirit and yada, yada, yada.
And this woman was supposed to do a show with Pharrell Williams
Simple Sam, I'm going to bang a quote, yeah? So it was, I came to tell you about sin.
Yes.
Yeah? That perverted homosexual spirit and the spirit of delusion and confusion has deceived many men and women.
Hallelujah.
Yeah? There are a lot of people that I'm aware of that struggle to deal with or have that spirit. Have I discriminated against them? Have I ever told them outright that I don't love you or that you're going to hell? I don't make that call. So basically, Simple Simon, for me, okay, so here's the problem.
Just take into account, you did take that out, you know, that is a snippet.
Yes, she said other things.
And apparently it's about Bishop Eddie Long, by the way.
In particular. So here's the thing. For me, right, if a person is said to be religious and they're following the doctrine of a religious text, yeah, and they're living the doctrine that they're following, if they quote that doctrine to you, I don't see that as being something particularly wrong, especially as it's not something that they've written or made up themselves. They are quoting the doctrine to you. Now, I know you guys have at least read the Bible, and I know that some of you may have even touched into the Quran. What those books in particular, I'm using those, the Sons of Abraham religions, those books in particular have very, very distinct and clear guidelines around homosexuality, the act, the way God sees the act, and redemption, and, you know, what it means to be involved and indulging in such acts. If somebody then quotes that to you, whether they do so with maliciousness or not needs to be added in into the equation, I guess, of course. But if somebody's quoting to you what is doctrine,
And what they believe.
Well, not so much what they believe, because crazy people believe crazy stuff.
Klu Klux Klan believe a lot of stuff.
The guy that went into the church in America and shot up the place, he believed that he was doing the right thing. It's not so much about that. But if you're talking about a religious doctrine that we have all, whether we like it or not, accepted to be, at least in some degree, to be the truth, yeah? Whether it is demographically, we've accepted it to be the truth, where the Islamic world accepts is the Quran and Islam to be true, and the Christian world accepts the Bible to be true. If that is the case and somebody's quoting that, I can't see what's wrong with that.
What Ellen DeGeneres sees wrong is that she has an ultimate belief that that is the case. Do you understand? So she does...
Can you tell them what the problem was in the first place?
What do you mean?
I haven't said the question at all.
Oh, yeah.
No, no, carry on. Just say it. Add it in there.
Well, no, you go ahead, man. I can't remember.
Well, this woman was going to perform on a show with Pharrell, like you said, mm-hmm. and on Ellen's show. And then Ellen respectfully declined the request for her to come after these comments had come to light. It was somebody had recorded it, posted it on social media. It had already been booked that he was going to come on the show with her. She was on one of his songs. And then she said, I don't want that woman on my show because Ellen DeGeneres is obviously gay. And she said, if she's got those views and she's made those comments about me and mine, she can't come to my house and perform on my stage, it's obviously.
They're calling it like a hateful speech. I said that she's being hateful. Now, my thing is this. I'm a bit like simple. My thing is this. Like, that's the religion, isn't it? That is how the religion has been from the day dot, right? I am not a Christian wholeheartedly. I don't believe in Christianity. That's not my thing, right? But that's their religion. If I don't agree with what they're saying in that religion, I don't follow that religion. I don't try and then change that religion for them and tell them that what your religion is bad, and if you don't change it, then, you know, you're going to be exercised. Like, she's not saying to them, she's saying to them that they're going to hell. If they don't believe that they're going to hell, then why are you following that religion?
Does anyone have a problem with what Ellen has done?
I have a small problem. Webb's here. Ellen DeGeneres is a talk show host. That's her job, just to be a talk show host. Her race, religion, creed, sexuality shouldn't really come into it. Because if someone like Miss Burrell's going to come on her show and air her views, her as a talk show host who should be open to everything, she plays devil's advocate in a respect, should have her on her show, let her talk her talk and have a debate about it, but not just say, I don't want you on my show because you don't like LGBT or my sexuality.
So hang on.
I think that's wrong.
So hang on a minute. Inadvertently, are we saying that...
if that was the case.
Trevor Noah has actually...
done the right thing.
Well, not even maybe done the right thing, but he's actually... he's actually taken the higher road. He's taken the Highland Road. He's taken Scottish Avenue.
Well,
because he's interviewed on the show a person. Maybe the show's not his. I get that dynamic. But he's interviewed a person who is, by her speech and by her rhetoric, diametrically opposed to his existence or his position in current society.
No. Not to the same level as possibly what this woman said.
But she's a racist.
But she you could say that she's a racist. I could say she's a racist. But there's other people out there that would say she hasn't actually said any racist views.
But then she, I'm saying Burrell woman hasn't really said anything homophobic.
Possibly, but they feel that they are.
It's a different thing because one of them was going to perform music on the show. It wasn't as much as it was a talk show. She wasn't going there to talk. She was going there to perform.
And she wasn't going to sing any anti-gay lyrics, was she?
Not that I know of.
The song is for that film about the black female pioneers. I forget the name.
Yeah. And the other one was it's a night show where they discuss news. Current topics, and one of them is a bit more lighthearted than the other. With all the comedy that Trevor Noah's show has, it's still a show about the news and politics. It's heavily drenched in politics.
It's a satirical political show.
Yeah, there you go. That's a nicer way than putting it, the way I was putting it. So I think it's a big difference. None of us seem to have a problem with what Trevor Noah did anyway, so that's that. So if we want to slam Ellen, like Web Sling is doing at the moment, then by all means, I don't have a problem with what Ellen did.
No. Web didn't slam it. What he did was what he said was about professionalism. It wasn't slamming.
Well, I disagree with him. He can have his view that he doesn't think that she should be dismissed from the show, but not for the reasons he's saying, because she wasn't going there to talk to him. That's what I'm saying. I don't see that as... You could say, well, because... people that perform, I'm sure, do sit down and talk with Ellen about their latest release or whatever film's coming out or whatever it is. So she could say, rather than not having her in the show, say, after you finish perform, would you be willing to talk about those comments that have been recorded? That's down to
the producer.
I'm going to ask another question.
I think Ellen's powerful enough in Hollywood now to be able to say that this is something I want to talk about. And everyone would know that would get serious ratings as well. They'd be quite happy for her to do that.
I'm very interested to know the list, because I don't watch Ellen. Very interested to know the list of people that's been on that show and see what type of dynamics she's had on that show. And if she's had people that's in the past possibly given anti-gay views or anti-racist views or whatever, and see if she's had them on the show. Because I want to know if this is setting a precedent for her saying to somebody, no, I'm not, you're not coming on my show openly, because she did it openly. She went on Twitter and she told people, yes, I've told her that, you know, I don't really want on the show anymore.
In addition to that, Simple Simon, yeah. In addition to that, what I want to know is the song that they were going to perform, was it a gospel song?
Well, I'm not too sure. It's a Pharrell's and her song, so I don't think it's very much going to be a gospel song. I think he was using her to sing. It could possibly be, but I can't remember. But
listen, it's a black film. It's going to have some gospel in it somewhere.
Yeah. What
I'm saying is, even if, let's just say it was a gospel song, yeah? Let's just say, for argument's sake, it was a gospel song. Yes. This woman's going on the show to sing a gospel song.
Yes.
For me, whether the individual says, quotes the doctrine or not, she's going to sing a gospel song. And the doctrine is from the gospel, isn't it?
As I said, they're trying to move the goalposts for this religion. And I'm just, in my head, I'm just thinking, if you don't think that this religion is correct, don't follow the religion.
Simple.
Stop trying to change up the religion.
Yeah, but nobody told her that she's trying to change religion. Who said anyone was trying to change religion?
A lot of people are trying to... Well, the fact that... Okay, we just touched on it before, that they've changed the laws to allow gay people to get married in church. Yes?
Yeah.
That is changing the religion.
Is it? Can they do it in church?
Yes.
Yes, it's in church.
They've even got...
They have pastors and preachers that are gay.
Yeah,
So...
Yeah, and to be honest, religion. As I said, it's not my religion, but... If I don't agree with this, I know that full well that it's not my religion because I don't agree with the things that's in there. Mm. So I'm just going to leave that religion alone and find a religion for me that agrees with the things that I agree with. Mm. I'm not going to go and try and change other people's religion and then tell them, you know what, you're doing is wrong. In fact, you can even I don't even have a problem with you telling somebody what they're doing in their religion is wrong, you know. In fact, you can say that all day long, but then you can't then try and change the thing. That's what I don't get. If they don't accept you, or that's not something that they want to do, then fair enough. You know, that's what I'm saying. As much as I don't agree, I think that Ellen maybe should have let the woman sing. I don't know. But if she's saying to them, you know, if they're going to church, people can say to them, you can't come into my church. And you can say to them, yeah, don't come into my show. So I get that. It's a tit for tat thing. I get it.
So Pharrell's now. So Pharrell's response, yeah, because he got asked some questions on there. Do you feel like Pharrell took on the argument, or do you think that his statement was a good way for him to defend himself? And
I think he dashed the woman under the bus.
He
dashed another black woman.
Pharrell, by the way, Pharrell said Pharrell went on the show without the woman, the demon woman. He went on the show. I don't know if he performed this song, but we heard a little snippet of an interview that he ended up doing with Ellen. And she asked him about, you know, what do you feel about those things? And he said, well, in 2017, nobody should have those kind of views. We need to leave that behind. I don't agree with those kind of things. He didn't mention her specifically. He even said, I love her. And then he quickly dashed that and levelized it by saying, I love her like I love everybody. So basically, she's not any more important to me than anybody else, but I don't agree with those particular views. So
does that not sound like he just contradicted himself?
But this is what I'm going to say. I'm going to say now, this is the question that I'm going to ask, yeah? What things should black people, men and women, stop doing in 2017? That's the question I'm going to ask.
That should come under the bus. That's that under the bus. Now, each of them said, you know what, there's a couple of... In the last week, I've heard a couple of bus dashing, yeah? This is one bus dashing. Serena, I don't know if she said it or not.
I don't think Serena said it.
Okay,
I think that's a fake.
All right, I'm going to leave Serena's one alone because that was I never dashed bus in. I was like, what am I dashing bus for? But I think, to be honest, with this one, yeah, she just dashed him under the bus. He dashed her under the bus. He could have just said, you know what? I would have told Ella before I even come on the show, you know what? She's not allowed to come on the show. I don't really want to chat about her on the show. You know what I mean?
For real.
If she can't come to defend herself on the show, I don't want to chat about her on the show.
For real.
And that's what Pharrell should have done. Mm. He's half black, half Filipino.
Why should he do?
Because he shouldn't be that. No, sorry, 2004. Because this is why. Because I think the LGBT community would have told them the same thing. They would have said, give me a gay person. I don't know.
R. Kelly.
Dr. Eddie Long.
Did you say R. Kelly?
Okay, you're gay.
Michael Barrymore.
Okay, yeah. If Michael Barrymore can't come on the show because he's of his views of almost
sex. Barrymore.
He's gay. We know he's gay. Yeah, but he's gay though, isn't he?
It's just a gay person.
It's
any gay.
All gay.
Can I finish what I mean?
All right, Stavros, there you go. Simple.
Right, so if he was, you know, you're not going to let him on the show because he's gay or his views about homosexuality or heterosexuality, even let's change it. He's on heterosexuality, I'm not letting him on the show. blah blah blah. The gay community will say we're not going on the show. That's what they'll do.
And this is part of, this is part of what I was talking about earlier about how the collective movements and which direction they're pushing. You understand? So like you said, the LGBT community would have stood behind it and said, all right, they ain't going on the show. They would have boycotted up the thing. And before you know it, no LGBT community members are involved.
I think what you guys are doing...
Blacks don't do that.
What you guys are doing is you're making this issue a black issue or a race issue. And it's...
Why not?
Yeah, well, it's not a race issue.
But it's... But, but sometimes it's not LGBT issue either, but they still make it about that.
No...
Yes. Yes.
Or in this case, it is. So, you know, so actually, pick a better example that you want to start using, because in this example, she said, "I don't want this person on my show, not because she's a woman, not because she's black, but because of the view she has against my kind of people."
Yeah, but even then,
God has the same view as far as the Bible's concerned.
And that's
the
point.
Yeah, but what's the
Helen, yeah, but she is, may not be a follower.
Is Ellen,
of Christianity.
Yeah, is Ellen religious?
She may be
an
atheist.
I don't care what Ellen is. For me, Pharrell said that that's meant to be his girl, or maybe now he's living in that. No, he's not his girl. No, but I've read articles that he said that that's his people. Yeah, right. So as far as I'm concerned, yeah, if that's meant to be your people, if they're not going to go scatter your people on live on air, you should tell them, nah, I'm not coming here to help you scatter my people.
Let me tell you guys.
All right, the question is Ellen DeGeneres bigger than Pharrell?
Yes.
She is.
Of course she is.
Yeah.
Ooh. There's a course about that.
In America, yes. Of course. Worldwide, no.
Is she?
In America,
Ellen DeGeneres is massive,
I know that she's massive, but let's not try.
Is Ellen DeGeneres bigger than Oprah?
No.
Oprah but is the Pharrell biggest. Is huge worldwide, bruv. And so, we're not even talking about
it. So are we looking at Helen worldwide or Helen just in America, in that territory?
Probably just in America.
Are you calling her Helen?
Whatever her name is.
Helen DeGeneres.
The gay woman.
Ellen DeGeneres.
The queer woman?
Oh, come on.
I don't think she goes under the... Under that quota.
She just goes under LGBT, don't she?
She's lesbian, isn't it? So you're...
She's married to...
She was just with the president getting a... some sort of award for her services to
women.
Not women, just
to the gay community.
Not just the gay community, just like, you're such a special person, you deserve this award. That was what it was.
Is Ellen married to the chick that was in Ally McBeal?
Yeah.
What chick? The black chick?
Let me change the subject, because we've been talking about this for a while. Yeah, I just call this woman, the black woman from Ally McBeal, a tasty meat. Yes. And my brother, Mr. Wolf, co-signed it and said the same thing
one time.
Now, some people might say that's misogyny.
Oh.
Now, one of the questions that we got sent into the show, so just to let you know, if you want questions sent into the show, you can contact us on all the social medias at ESN Podcast and send your questions or your views in, and we will address them on the show, as we are about to do right now. Somebody wanted to talk about misogyny in the black community specifically in the black community. So do you think terminology like a good meat could that be classed as misogyny? Is this something wrong?
I think some people need to be, you know, there's too much sensitivity going on, man.
Did we define misogyny last week, didn't we?
We gave the definition. In the barbershop, right?
Yeah. Shall we go back and define it again, just so we get it clear?
It was a hatred for women.
It was, in general, a hatred.
I don't know if
you... A dislike and a hatred.
But I'll tell you what, when we're talking about that lady from...
Ali Machiavelli.
We need to find out what her name is.
Let me tell you something. There's no hatred there.
Mr. Wolf, I'm in agreement with you. I'm going to go as far as to say, that if a man, I would say a black man, or I'll say even the man around these table, if they say...
Be for yourself.
Somebody is a good meat.
Yes.
These men love meat, innit? Like, there is no meal that can occur without a meat. So if these men say she's a good meat, that means that they love her effectively, like, or they love something about her. So I don't see the misogyny there. I don't see it.
Well, Hala's just brought up a picture of this woman. What's her name?
Lisa Nicole Carson.
God damn it.
At the moment, she's not looking her best, bruv.
I think
I think she was on drugs for quite a bit.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Oh,
she was looking good at the day back in the day, but right about now, she's not looking her best.
I only really got one question to ask. Is she better than Tiona Paris?
No.
I don't think any woman is. Simple. I don't think any woman is.
Wow.
Well, let's get into some misogynistic.
We're gonna go from misogynistic to start rating a woman.
You know, hang on, hang on. We're gonna come back to chauvinism. What's chauvinism?
Ooh, that's a problem.
I think we're more chauvinist than misogynist.
We're definitely not misogynist. We love women.
No, but you say that, but the way that some people look at how mannerisms are and how we deal with women on a day-to-day basis, people could think that we're misogynist.
Yeah, because
no, it's not how we talk about. Not how we deal with.
No, no, no.
Any woman that has dealt with me couldn't say that I'm misogynistic.
Yeah, but people that have looked from the outside in, women that have looked from the outside in can blatantly say that you're misogynist.
How?
Because the way that you deal with her in certain thresholds, even the way that you speak to her in certain fashions, people could say, I don't think that you would speak to another man like that. You speak to her like that because she's a woman. That's the misogynist way that you're speaking to her.
Nah, I don't know, man.
Even the fact that you call your woman woman sometimes.
What do you mean? Like her? Call her woman?
Yeah.
No.
You've never called your woman woman. Woman, no. Ever in life?
I don't think so.
I'm sure you've called a woman.
I don't think so.
I'm sure you have. Even they're saying the word that people are calling women women and females is now seen as to be a misogynist way of describing a woman.
Can I just point out that when we're talking about misogyny as well, although the term is, you know, a hatred or dislike of women, it could also be portrayed. So it's not just about I want to hit you or I hate women. I don't like talking to them. Stay away from me. I don't want to marry a woman, you know, or, you know, them kind of things. It could also just be simple things like, well, I believe the woman's place is in at home. She shouldn't go to work. But she should do the cooking. And
that's,
you know,
right.
But well, these.
I'm only joking, ladies. I can hear them right now.
Oh my God, listen to Mr. Wolf.
I won't lie to you. My mouth was open like that.
No, damn, bring me meat.
You need to add on to this, and I think this is where a lot of it comes from. We need to not add on stuff like catcalling. They would see that as misogynist.
I never did catcalling. You know?
Yeah, but catcalling is seen as misogynist way that's of dealing with it. Like, talking to women in a derogatory fashion.
What's catcalling?
Derogatory like fashion.
Hey, baby. Hey, babes. Come. Hey. Hey. I don't cat call. No, but they do that. No, but they do that for everything in Nigeria. They do that if they want to get the man to bring meat to the to you.
Can or I just wait? Can I just address one thing?
The man said
Wahala said buff puss.
I guarantee you, there's about four women out there. Four, maybe five women, depending on how many listeners we got, that will tell you that a man has said to them, "Oh, I buff puss."
If you're in Jamaica, that might not be such a.
You see what I mean? Buff puss or nice pom or something like that. Something that, with buff.
That's just vulgar, though. That is just
but it's
straight
seen as
vulgar.
But it is so for some women that is a day to day thing. There's women. Right, I've been reading threads chatting with women, and they've been saying on a day to day basis they are actually going through and having discussions. Where men are just, you know, saying that to them on a regular, like talking to them in a derogatory manner on a regular basis.
No, but real talk, where do people learn that?
From other men.
But like, don't they have women in their families and that?
Yeah, and they don't, they in their heads, they think of it like this. It's not my mum, it's not my sister, so I can talk to her how any way that you want. Yeah, but you can't talk to my sister like that.
The world is circular, like things are going to come back around, isn't it?
Well, I think that's a lot of the things that people are talking about when they talk about misogyny. Like the way that black men treat black women. I'm going to be real. In 2016, I've seen some ridiculous ways about the way that black men have treated black women. Even just being in the gym and the way that they've spoken about black women. Like the way that they said that. I've heard other black men say that, you know, I'd rather, you know, go out with a white woman because they treat themselves better. These black women, they don't know how to treat themselves. I've been in the gyms where they said, you know, I don't really like the dark ones and stuff like that. Only like, not even really like light-skinned girls. I want white girls only.
Maybe they're not.
You've heard somebody say this?
I've heard somebody say this to me.
They're not woke, bro.
I don't even think there's anything to do with this stupid woke. That's just a nonsense. Like, they're telling people as black as staff, telling me, you know, that's a bromance already. Telling me that, you know, they want light skin or white girls only. Like, how can you be saying that? How can you be openly saying that you don't want somebody that reflects the same way that your, I don't know how your mum's been, so maybe their mum's been terrible to them, I don't know, but the same way that your mum looks or something like that, you just don't reflect that.
Can I touch on this subject? Because Stavros has no issue with shade. Did I mention this last week?
No.
All right. I don't look at shade when I'm looking.
You don't look at shade when you're looking
at... When I'm looking at a woman, I will look at shade. I'm just looking at
Webs, I don't know what's wrong with you, man. When I'm looking at a woman, Stavros has a preference for black women. So I'm looking at a black woman, and I don't, let me not say I don't see shade, but it has no relevance. It bears no relevance on whether I find you attractive or not. If you're dark skin or light skin, it doesn't make a difference. Are you buff? Do you have a big bottom? Like, do you have a pretty face? Do you have a nice smile? Yeah. Are you rocking natural hair? These are the, you know, are you wearing very little or no makeup? These are the things that I like. Whether you're dark skin or light skin is not a problem. But if somebody says they have a preference for a darker or light skin person, as much as I don't get it personally, so be it. Because people don't have a problem when people say I like a dark-skinned man. So why is it they have a problem when that same dark-skinned man says I prefer the light-skinned woman? Why is what is this double standard about?
There's a preference, and there's ones where people are saying that they're ugly, they look like this, look like that.
I'll be honest with you, women, black women in particular, they get a lot of stress, man. So this is just an extra added thing that like people are adding on to it. So that's why it seems so, like you're so talking about a double standard. It seems a lot worse because black women get run through the mill on a lot of stuff. If it's not hair, if it's not big bottom, if it's not breasts, if it's not, you know, like there's always something.
What do you mean run through the mill?
As in, can they cook? What's their hair like? Do they wear makeup?
They get critiqued more than any other race and gender.
A black woman gets critiqued more than any other human being.
Is that because
by themselves and by others as well?
By themselves.
Is that because we expect more from them?
It's a thing. It's partly that.
Yes.
Sorry. Is it we as black men or we as society?
We as black men. I think black men blatantly expect more from black women than they do from any other women. In a strange way, whilst putting them down at the same time. Yeah. It's so mad. I expect you to be a queen, but I'm gonna call you a bitch. You know what I mean? That's how it is. Mm. It's a madness. It's that they give them an unrealistic expectation of what they expect them to be.
Let's not try to generalize, though.
Okay, I'm not generalizing, because what I think it is.
I like a balanced view, and this is Mr. Wolf, and there are a lot of black men who treat their black women like queens.
Of course there is.
No, we're not saying that. What we're saying here is...
You're black men bashing. That's what I'm hearing.
No, it's...
And I feel hurt.
Fair enough. But like, if you're... Don't get me wrong. There's always going to be...
I've got you wrong.
There's always going to be the undercurrent, the people that are doing the things that are expected, the people that are doing, you guys will probably say, the right thing. Mm-hmm. And then there's going to be the noise that pollutes that. And the problem is noise tends to be louder than the people that are doing what they're supposed to be doing.
What do you think the majority is then? Do you think the majority of...
Here's the guess.
When you have... All right, and you take black men...
Yeah.
That you know or you know of.
Yes.
Or what you see.
Yes.
Do you feel that the majority of black men you see are treat and talk about and are good with black women? Mediocre or below par? Subpar. The majority.
That's a good question.
That's a good question. But then again, it comes down to your individual circle. So
That's what I said, specifically. Asking.
I would say that there's an overwhelming majority of men that are doing right by black women.
What, in our circle?
In our circle.
I would say it's quite balanced, you know? It depends on what you think of doing right.
Yeah, okay.
Because I think there's a couple of guys that are okay, but I wouldn't necessarily say that they're doing right.
Okay, what do you think is... What are you accounting into that wrong category?
Just a lot of what they spoke about, isn't it?
Yeah, mistreatment to the black girls. Mistreatment,
bad language.
How I think they value a woman, I wouldn't necessarily say is what I would like somebody to value, somebody that would be like my daughter or my wife or anybody. I don't think that they value a woman to a level like I think that they should do. I'm not to say that sometimes the women that they having this problem with are women that you might necessarily decide to value because they're not showing the value themselves. But I could say there's probably other women out there that have tried hard to be a good woman for these men and they're not necessarily on it. And they've devalued them. That's what I was going to say. So, and I think a lot of... I want to say that us guys are misogynists. I want to say that we're misogynists, but I can see people saying that we've got misogynist views. Does that make sense?
Yeah. So you looked up chauvinism right now. What is it?
Apparently, it was extreme patriotism.
Eh? See how words.
Okay, go to the Urban Dictionary for chauvinist pick.
No, you don't want chauvinism.
Because, dictionary. Well, whatever dictionary.
No, I want the proper definition, man.
Because the chauvinist pig, or the definition of that in society, has got nothing to do with that definition there. It's about, you know, the mistreatment of women.
But do you think that a lot... Okay, let's... You know what? Let's, the thing that we need to focus on, and I know it's a bit of a shame, is you're going to have to look at the media to say what you see as a stereotypical black man in the media.
Okay, let me just stop you there.
Okay.
Hold that. I've found male chauvinist as opposed to the chauvinist.
Okay.
And a male chauvinist is a male who patronizes, disparages, or otherwise denigrates females in the belief that they are inferior to males and thus deserving of less than equal treatment or benefit.
So I would say male chauvinist is more than misogyny in the black community. I mean,
you do get it in some. Nah. You do get it in some communities and even in some religions where they put
the Indian community has a big problem with this.
Of course, they do. There's many other I've just looked at a video just today, and it was I saw what, how many 54,000 Indian women got raped last year.
Mm-hmm.
Madness, yeah. Absolute madness. But that's
a whole topic, another topic in itself. Where,
and I think we need to touch it at one point, because the Indian rapes is just getting ridiculous. Just absolutely ridiculous.
It's not getting.
Yeah, okay,
it's done been ridiculous.
Sorry, but I found another definition of chauvinism, so I had to just say this one. A man who believes that women are naturally less important, intelligent, or able than men, and so does not treat men and women equally.
That's similar definitions. What similar. Said.
Yeah, thank you for reiterating the same
thing. I think, to be honest, again, as I said, going by what you're saying in the media,
eggnog,
and looking at the media, if you just look at, let's just take one genre of music. Oh, yes. Let's look at hip hop. Hip hop is the biggest genre of music that there is at the moment, apart from maybe rock. Rock and hip hop are the two biggest genres.
Reggae.
Reggae.
Duh.
But I'm not sure that I want you to go by that angle.
I am, because the reason why I'm saying that is
the media has a way of really twisting things and highlighting what is negative.
But I'm saying to you, I'm going by what you see in the world.
Things black men shouldn't do in 2017.
On a day-to-day basis. Do you know what I mean? What you're seeing on a day-to-day basis with the equivalent to what they're showing you on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah, but is that reality?
It's not necessarily reality. What some people, it's reality, because people are mimicking what they're seeing on the telly. Like, when did you grow up in your... Okay, let's be real, yeah? When did males, especially black males, start calling women bitches? When was that just the norm? Because it is becoming the norm. In fact, it's becoming the norm with women calling each other bitches. When did that become the norm?
It became the norm for men, black men in particular, around the late 80s.
When what? When who started doing it more?
Earlier than that. You think it's earlier than that?
Yeah.
Go watch all your black exploitation. Before our time. So I don't,
okay,
I don't think
we could
assess when that is.
No, no, you're right. Black exploitation. I forgot about that.
Are we saying that the calling of women bitches is a black thing? Because I'm not.
I'm not saying that. But I think...
No, I think it's different. I think in Caucasian community, the word bitch was used for women, but it was used as a scathing...
Insult.
Whereas in the black community, it seems to be almost like the N-bomb.
Yes. Black bitch, bitches has now become almost a term...
The female equivalent.
Of a description of a female. That is it. Bitches. You are a bitch.
I've found, as the years have gone on,
like a term of endearment. Ah, that's my bitch, man.
Yeah, but what kind of term? It's a dog.
I know it's a dog. It's a female dog.
I've personally found, as the years have gone on, that I'm hearing it less and less. I'm not hearing it.
Anymore. I don't hear it. I hear it quite.
I think maybe we're talking about American culture. I think we're so seeped in American culture. Sometimes we kind of discount our immediate circle, because I know we don't call women that. Unless we're insulting them, yeah. So it's not just a term that you call a woman, yeah. Me personally, I'll use chick. This is Stavros. I use chick.
You don't like it.
That's your business.
Like, you call them a woman. That's
men call men bitches.
Yeah, and you know why they call them bitches?
Because they're acting like a woman.
Which means that's meant to be bad.
No, like a female dog.
I think American black culture, they use that word bitch to describe a female. That's it now. I'm not even using it to insult you.
The problem is
American. That bitch gave me a discount when I went into the store, man. I went over there and thanked her. That's it.
Yeah, like, the thing about it is African American culture permeates the planet, the globe.
That's the problem.
So just like the popularity of weed, for example, in Africa, like now they're using this type of language. Like boys are going back from America, going to Ghana, Nigeria, and what have you. They're using these terms.
Bitch,
this bitch, man, you know? You know what I mean? I got my bitches, man, you know? Like, so, and it's spreading.
Was there a T in
that? What? No, bitches. Yeah, bitches.
There was no T.
It was B-I-S-H.
Like a brush.
Yes. Bitches.
We don't need the T, man.
So the problem is the culture permeates. And this comes back to what we were talking about with trends and stuff like that. Like, it's really weird. I don't know what it is about black people, but when we do something, it just becomes trendy.
I don't want to tiptoe around the actual thing question. I want people to say yes or no. Do you think there's a problem with black misogyny in 2017?
In Mr. Wolf's circle?
No, in friends. General.
In my circle, association circles, I know a lot of people. And I'll go as far as to say no.
So you think in general?
I think that men respect women more than they don't.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a simple. There you go.
Simple Sam.
I'm torn on this one because I can only see from my circle. And I don't. Yeah. So from my circle, I would say that it's more respect than not. But okay. I can see why other people are saying that.
Can I ask you? Okay. So let me go around the table. Let me see what everybody says. And then I'm going to ask a question. Go on, Mr. Webster.
Yeah, sorry. No, men are very misogynistic towards women. I see it in not necessarily my circles, but other circles I'm affiliated with. I see it, and it's quite disturbing sometimes.
Okay, so what's he saying that he thinks there is, Mr. Staff?
See, this is the thing, because in my circle it's a no, and I don't necessarily mix with any other circles. So, like the black circles. So I've got people I work with and whatnot, but. So, but obviously, culturally, when I'm looking at, it's just the media, what I can see in the media. In the media, it seems poor. But that media is American media again. So in the media, I would say it's we're not doing good enough as black men and how we treat our black women. But in my circles, it's we're doing all right. We could do better. Don't get me wrong. Mm-hmm. And not everyone is good. I'm not saying I'm not saying there aren't any bad eggs. But on the whole, I'm not really, you know, looking down at my nose at a lot of my circle and how you're treating.
I really think that media takes a big influence on the way how people think.
Can I ask you another question? Which is a touch on that question. Okay, so you said your immediate circles. A couple of you said you, Simple Simon, and you, Yemi, you said your immediate circle. Stav, you kind of said your immediate circle as well, yeah? I'm assuming you're just talking about the men. So if you was to ask the women in your immediate circle, the black women that are there, I don't even think it's about black men. Just say women in general.
Say it.
Right? If they were to ask, I'm talking about a lot of them, do you think that there's a black misogyny in 2017 within black men? Do you think that they would say no?
They would probably
say yes. I think that if you base it on what we have said in terms of our circle, I think that they'd say no.
No,
if
I'm saying
you talk about in general, media.
Because I never said, people said your circles. I said, in general, is there misogyny in the black?
I think it's perceived
Simple Simon, if you ask the women, they'd say yes.
And why do you think that is? Because they have more interaction with black men out of their circle, no?
They have more interaction with men in general, period, and more interaction out of their circle, yes.
So that's why I'm saying to you, for you to keep saying my circle, that means that you're not listening. You've just discarded
this is what it comes down to. If from my experience, from what I see, Kashmir. I only see my circles. So I hear stories from, all right, Stavros is the type of dude that sits down and talks to a woman and lectures her about how you need to find a good man by doing this and that. And then I'll talk to men as well. Same thing. This is what you need to do to find a good woman. So I hear stories when I'm having these kind of conversations with women. Like, why is it so hard to find a good man? The dude I dated last week did X. The dude I dated last month did Y. You know, my boyfriend from a few years ago was doing Z. And I'm like, wow, I don't know. And I'm always surprised by what they're telling me. I do not know men like this. It's like, even some of the worst men I know, like some of the dudes that treat you poorly, don't do the type of things that I hear from these women. I don't personally experience these things. So yes, you're right. I do hear these kind of stories from women, but I never see it in my face.
And that's simple. I mean, that's why I gave the view of personal, because personally I don't see it, but I know that outside of that there will be that. So with the women, they will say yes, because they're seeing or they're being in contact with a whole plethora of mans from different walks of life. So yes, they will see it, whether we like it or not.
Yeah, but it's like we discarded those people in you, because you said my circle. But in the end, those people are part of your circle, so you've got to take those stories.
No, but they're not part of my circle.
But the women are.
The women are
part yeah, but of my so circle. I'm saying that from your experience, those women are giving you what they're explaining to you. So that is part of your experience. As much as you might not have been directly involved in that situation, mm-hmm. from the women's experience, that has now become part of what you know men. Mm-hmm. That has now become part of your experience, isn't it?
Barely.
So then you got to think about that. For me, no, men are misogynist in a disgusting way sometimes.
Men
but I don't
or
think,
black men?
I think men. Okay. But black men, obviously, is what we're discussing. And I think, yes, black men in 2017, misogynist. I think black men do look down on black women. I think they do that quite often. I think they do.
Oh man.
Okay, even if you want to go, okay, let's go to even our cultural way.
Do we look down on our sisters and our mothers?
No, you have to, again, you're looking at yourself, you're looking at it through your own eyes for yourself. What he's talking about here is you're looking at the micro and he's talking about the macro. He's talking about the issue at large. He's talking about the culture at large, the behavior at large, the view at large.
So
if he's talking about that, he's right.
If Mr. Wolf sees a fine looking woman online or a photograph or someone, I'll say, oh my gosh, that is nice meat.
That's not necessarily being misogynistic.
You know what?
What's the big deal?
Here's the thing. Imagine you have a sister and there's 10 random black men in front of you that you don't know. Yeah? And if you had to bet money on her being able to pick, she had a choice of four. She could go on a date with four of these 10. And if you had to bet money, is one of those men going to be above and beyond what you feel is decent? Or sorry, just meet the level, the criteria that you feel is a decent man treating my sister decently. Out of 10.
Gaza.
How much would you be willing to bet? Would you make, out of 10? Let's say she's going to go on a date with all 10. Yeah, sorry, forget the four. I don't know why I said that.
Yeah, but
there's 10 men. She's gonna go on a date with all these 10 black men. How sure are you that one,
being a
just
good
one
man
of these 10 men is gonna treat her? Forget how much money makes and all that. Just, is he going to treat her well?
You're gonna ask.
Yeah,
like
but hold on.
Sure,
listen.
No, I wouldn't be sure. I ain't bet no money on that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You could never know. But being a good
man. No.
And being misogynistic and chauvinistic is two completely different.
See, you cannot say that a good man. So you're saying to me, a good man can believe that a woman is below him, worse than him.
Yeah, but
blah blah blah.
Hold on. Just a minute ago, we were saying that we're not going by the exact terms of the misogynistic
view. That is what we're talking about.
So am I now misogynistic because I said that good girl is fine and she's a good me?
I didn't say that's misogynistic. I said some people could view it as misogyny.
Okay.
I said catcalling and stuff like that because.
But it's not though. Me saying those words is not misogynistic.
You say
those
in your eyes.
No,
it's not
in terms of the definition of the word misogyny.
If you
want to
go back,
it's not.
Do you know the lines are blurred when it comes to how what definitions of words people are taking things.
Let's
and changing
go
them
by
and
the
them
definition.
Also, you have to take into account here that the recipient of the behavior, their opinion is probably more important than the
that's
person.
Yeah,
but
you've got to call a spade a spade. You can't start sugarcoating.
No, but it's not a case of sugarcoating
it.
If I say, let's say that, for me, it starts like this. If you say to this woman in her face, you're a good meat, yeah? She's already.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to laugh.
What fool really is going to
come up to a woman? Hold on. Say that again.
There are fools.
Come on.
Okay.
Then I'm a fool because Stavros will tell a woman to her face.
You're a good meat. A good meat.
And you know what? If she got offended by that, tell her shut up and get out of the way.
Right, but.
Yeah, my
face.
It's not disrespectful because I don't mean anything by it.
No, but you see, this is the problem. This is what I'm saying. This misogynist
is not as misogynist.
It is because she's saying to you that she finds that offensive, and you have. So let me finish. You have no respect for the fact that she finds that offensive. You have no respect for that.
By exact definition, you're being a chauvinist.
Why?
Yes.
Because you don't care what she thinks.
Yes. I don't care what anyone thinks. So it's not about whether
you see it now.
Listen.
You see it now. Breaks down. You care about what your mum thinks.
No.
You care about what your dad thinks.
If I think I'm right. Yeah, and you can't give me a reason, a good enough reason for me where you've proved me wrong, then I don't really.
But
your opinion means nothing.
This is
going
to prove wrong. This is somebody's feeling. They don't feel that is acceptable for you to call.
Okay,
so they're not happy with that.
Can I just
and
say
you're
something?
You're telling them shut up. You're happy because I'm calling you.
Can I say something?
I'm calling you a side lump of breast or whatever.
Can I say something?
Side breast is not the premium of meat.
Can I say something, please?
I will chicken wing.
Can I say something? So if I went up to her and said, something a bit more delicate, like
you're beautiful.
No, because behold, even then,
a lady. Yeah,
well, your shoes, you know, your what you're wearing today looks really nice. Mm-hmm. If I went up to a woman and said that, and she said, "What was it you said?" I said,
"Mr. Wolf went up to a lady,
lazy sometimes."
When I said she's a good meat, and what did you say? They took offense to that. Yeah,
she said, "I take offense to you saying that."
But then I was saying,
"It's
same
just
thing.
The way that you approach the woman." But some women actually like those kind of terms.
I need to finish this before we continue on. I need to finish this. If I went up to a woman and said, "I think you're dressed really nicely today," she said, "I find that offensive." It's the same in my head. That you're just chatting rubbish. It's just that simple. So, and the thing is, now for whatever reason, you guys may agree with me when I say in that respect. All of a sudden you feel, well, she's got no reason to say that. He's not trying to try a thing with her. He's just complimented her on how she looks. And you feel now that I've done that in a diplomatic and polite way. So when she says she has a problem with it, you all of a sudden feel, well, yeah, she does have a problem. She's made a problem out of nothing. Where I think it's the same thing with the meat.
Yeah, but come on. You're calling somebody a piece of meat. Bloody, and shelved.
Huh?
Packaged meat.
No, you're adding all these things.
Okay,
up,
so what is, what type of meat is it? It's a meat, isn't it? You can call her a human, innit? If you said twerk, oh, look at you, you're human. Oh. Then I can say, you know what? That's
fine. She is meat, though. See? Men are meat. Women are meat. We're
come
humans
on,
are,
bruv. You're,
we're nah, meat.
You're reaching.
Yeah, when you start reaching, being,
I may be reaching.
Like
I may be
that,
reaching.
Then it's, you start acting.
I think that there's a respectful way and a disrespectful way to approach a woman, innit? So if you're being disrespectful, you're being disrespectful. Are you being misogynistic?
Do you think this is the reason why Nicki Minaj and Meek Mill broke up?
No, I don't think this is the reason. I think because Meek Mill has had the biggest, worst year of his life. That's why they broke up. But let's catch on this, because there's a lot of things I want to catch on with regards to this. There's another thing that I had a debate on online about it. And a lot of women said, a lot of black women as well, said that we don't defend, like, black men don't defend their women.
I always do.
Like, okay, well, okay, so if... let's use the situation that we came now, yeah?
Even the ones that have been bad to
Let me finish. All right? I'm not talking about you, but you're saying not their women, not your women, not your woman, you know? Just black
generally
women.
Generally, black
right, so
women. I would defend
goes
them.
Up to a woman and says to her, oh, yes, you're a good meat.
I don't like the way you said that. I wouldn't put it like
yes.
that. Doesn't
his
I'm
head.
Not Pat Butcher. I'm not Pat Butcher.
Touches his balls, everything. Oh, you're a good meat. Right? And she says, you know what? I find that offensive, you know? I don't like that you've done that. And then Stav says to her, well, you know what? Piss off your bitch. Blah, 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 yeah?
Mm.
Right? Would you defend her?
That's a good question.
Would you defend that woman?
It depends in... I don't know. It depends on the circumstances, man.
What are the circumstances?
In life, sorry, Simple Simon. Sorry, no, actually, sorry. Give me your circumstances. I can't take any words out of your
mouth. No, I was just saying that depends on the environment, the circumstances.
You're just there. You're watching it. You're seeing this happen.
I wouldn't be around someone that would really disrespect a woman like
he's
that.
He's done it. Just not trying to change it. He's done it. What would you do in that situation?
Who, me?
Yeah, you've done it.
I don't like the way you're tossing my name into calling
me
bitches.
No, because you're the one
that's
calling
them
me, innit?
But I didn't say bitch.
Okay, fair enough.
I
mean. Any man, it could be a stranger. You're on the street.
Yes.
You'll see a woman on the street.
Yes, I would defend the woman. Seen a woman, I've seen a guy beat a woman in public, and I've done something about it.
What did you do?
I stopped it, bruv.
Okay, that's
No long thing. I walked past, and I thought, am I going to do something about this? And another guy saw it, and I thought, let's go and do something. And even if I was on my own, I still would have done something. You know?
Okay, but that's beating. I'm talking about somebody pestering the woman. So
same
beating
thing.
Beating is
even
extreme.
At work, I've seen it and I've had to defend the woman.
In pestering. Somebody's
work is different. Work is always different. So don't include work. It's your part of your job, isn't it?
I'm talking about on the street. You're walking on the street.
Not
some woman's going psst.
What's the point you're trying to make, Wahala?
I'm saying that I don't think. Do you know what I'm saying? A lot of women were saying to me that they don't think that men will defend them, and I'm asking if you think that's the case.
Would you?
Would I defend a woman?
Yeah, I think it depends on the circumstances.
It
would depend.
For me, it's again the circumstances. There's times when I would defend them, and there's times when I'll be like, "Well, I'm not even 100% sure whether or not you're gonna even like this or not," because that's my problem with women at times. There's
it's
some
the world
disrespectful
general.
Things that women.
So you're blaming the woman now?
No, there's some disrespectful things that women don't find disrespectful. And are happy to have done.
Victim
and some women
shame.
Are like that.
Victim
and there's
shame.
You're a joker. And there's other situations where they're not. Now, if, like, the example that was used was a woman was approached by a man. the man, the woman basically was like, no, thank you. And then the man dashed water on her. Dashed a bottle of water on the woman.
Mr. Wolf has got many a number on off the back of things like that, you know.
Dashing water.
No, not water. Oh, he went and gone consoled the victim, innit?
Consoled the victim.
You're,
well,
you're
you know when...
Crimey man!
You know when...
that's Drake business there.
Yeah.
When a woman is getting pestered by a guy, when a woman's getting pestered by a guy and, you know, you could see, flipping hell, man, you can see this woman's getting frustrated and then you just go over there, yeah, I can see your frustration.
But are you defending them to get pulled?
Yeah, that's what he's doing.
Are you not defending them because they are...
He's not doing it
in my latter years. Yes.
Nah, look, Simple Simon, yeah, I can say wholeheartedly, hand on heart, in the days when we used to rave, there has been more than one woman that I've rescued.
Yes.
And not rescued for my own benefit either. I've rescued, like, I see man holding her hand
and not necessarily holding hand and then got the and then entered.
That's what I'm saying. No,
just rescued and just had a good old chat.
Not even a good old chat. I have properly rescued woman and said, look, you look like you're uncomfortable. I whisper in her ear, are you all right with this? You look like you're uncomfortable. Oh, yeah, help me. And I'll take her away. Simple as that.
I think we've all done it, apart from Webbs. I think we've all done it.
Wow.
Webbs is the lecherous one. The sticky-fingered one, as he likes to call himself.
He's the one pestering.
No, but I wouldn't. I think he's probably done it.
No, I think out of everyone, he, when he's ready, can be as emotional as Stav. So... he can also...
It's really my week this week, man.
You ain't even been touched, bro.
He can also... Webbs, I think we push a lot of things to make Webbs sound like a disgusting man. But he is actually the type of person that will probably be the first one to be asking the woman, are you all right? Are you all right? But then if she gives him any lip, he'll cuss her. He'll be the first to cuss. He'll be the first to console. It's weird. He's got no in between. Right.
The CNC music factory.
He's got no in between.
Cuss and console.
But it's simple. If I'm coming to ask you if you're all right, and you're being abusive back towards me, fuck you then.
No, but seriously, Webbs.
What? Isn't that what Wahala's going on about?
That's no, because I've come to help you and you're taking it the wrong way.
Yeah, but here's the problem, though.
He said being abusive. So if she's been abusive to him, then he's got the right to be abusive.
Exactly. Yeah, but the problem is, yeah, in that kind of scenario, if someone's being pestered and hassled, she don't necessarily know that you're...
You're coming to be good.
Like, you could be coming with a new angle.
You got to be smooth. It depends, like...
Do you know what I mean? No, like, I'm not even being funny. It's true.
Me and Simple were coldies, innit? We've been rolling since we were 16. We rolled together, innit? So we know the certain moves that we do, innit? So there's certain times when you might see a woman and a man's pestering her and blah, blah, blah. And man's like Simple or Wahala will just move to the woman and start dancing with her. Like, just take her away from the man and start dancing. The man will be looking at you vexed, but then you'll be like, what, bruv? Nah, this is my chick. I know her, innit? Blah, blah, blah.
Mm.
And then later she'll thank you for that. Right, so that's it. So that's a different move.
So let me get this right. What you're saying is that you just went up to a woman, took her, and grinded up against her without her permission.
I didn't grind.
there was no grinding.
Wow, is that how you do it? Just take a woman and just start dancing with her because what you're saying is that you feel this woman needs saving. So hold on. What you're saying is that the woman's lesser than you. She's weaker than you.
She needs saving.
Wow.
Are you saying that? Yes, but male chauvinist says that a woman is not equal to a man. She cannot deal with the situation by herself because if it was a man, you would leave. You wouldn't be there.
I like the way you dropped
it. I just gotta jump. But because it's a woman and you can't deal with the situation, me as the man have to put on the S on my chest and come in and try and save you.
Staff,
Mr. Mel,
the animal's kingdom. Simple
Simon is gonna say that you're 100% correct. But here the problem is, like, there's double standards within the standards. Always, understand? There's always double standards within the standards.
So do we not believe in the animal's kingdom?
Well, no. Well, we do believe in the animal's kingdom, but again, at the same time, what he's talking about there comes onto the idea of equality. And whether we like it or not, men and women are not equal. Do you understand what I'm saying? There's parity, but they're not equal, whether we like it or not. So
I think we're equal when we're not the same.
Yes, I agree with Stavros.
We have to understand what I mean when I say not equal. I'm not saying that...
I get what you're trying to say. You said parity.
Which is why I say we're not the same.
It's better you... say it the way that Stav said it, because the way that you can say it could be
the example I always give, because I say this about as well, and you get ready for the impact when people don't like saying that. When I say we're equal, but we're not the same, and then some people take that the wrong way. And the way I always put it is that imagine you have a scale, and on one side you have a ton of lead, and on the other side you have a ton of feathers. They're both a ton, but obviously they just look different. There's a different dynamic to both sides, but they both weigh the same.
But if you ran into the lead, you get hurt.
There you go. We're not the same. We're equal, but we're not the same. That's what I'm saying. And on that note, we have reached the end of episode 2.
Teona Paris?
Man whispered Teona Paris.
Wherefore art thou, Teona?
Teona.
For those who are listening and wondering what Teona Paris is about, we kind of concluded that
she's the baddest chick.
She's a good meat.
A good mate.
Are we putting it on 2016 or are we putting it on 2017 as well?
We don't know what she looks like 2017.
So we put it off. So Teona Paris is the baddest in 2016. Above and beyond. That's above and beyond Beyonce. Above and beyond Minaj of Nicki.
Yes.
Above and beyond.
Oh, Nana.
Rihanna.
The whole reason this whole queen came up in the first place is because we were discussing the Meek Mill and Nicki Minaj breakup. And Wahala was saying that at the time, for the world, Nicki Minaj was the baddest girl in the game. Like, that's what people were seeing. Like, the baddest chick in the game by far was Nicki Minaj.
And
Meek Mills was the king because he had the baddest chick in the game.
Simple Simon disagreed. And mentioned
When Jay-Z said, I got the baddest chick in the game wearing my chain. He had the baddest chick in the game wearing his chain.
That was the truth.
At this time, I think Meek Mills even stole that line and used it for Nicki. Yeah, maybe Nicki maybe said that about Meek Mills because you know he's a bit.
But you know what Drake said?
What?
I don't want to hear about this ever again. Not even when she tell you that we're better as friends.
But at the time, I think Nicki Minaj was the baddest chick in the game.
Man's gonna hear that line in his dreams.
I don't think she was the baddest chick in the game, but I think in the world of social, she was the baddest chick in the game.
I'm saying Teona Paris is upending all of these ladies.
This is the lady in Chirac now. What's the other film she was in?
Yeah.
She was in there where you bought people.
And that film, Chirac, is not very
good.
Did
you say the film was called Debt or You Bought People?
Yeah.
The Chirac film is not great.
Natural hair, by the way. Natural hair.
Just the way that she looks in that is fantastic.
Do you think that in 2017...
Lecherous comments.
Do you think that in 2017, the way that women are going to be looked at... Let's use black women, because white women are always the same, always blonde... That's the normally their top. That is their top thing, isn't it? Blonde hair, blue eyes,
and pencils thin.
Yeah,
so that's architecture.
But do you think that it's changing a lot with black women now? With especially especially 2016, 2015. I'll say those 2 years was a big push for the natural hair.
Yeah, I think a lot of black women are going for the natural.
You know what happened?
A lot of
Stavros. And ESN happened.
Oh, wow. Come on, like, we took over. The whole world is involved in it. That's another black Twitter thing.
Stavros is taking some responsibility. I push forward for the natural hair movement, and I think we all did. I'm gonna take, even if it's a grain of a percentage, I'm gonna take that grain and make a rest.
What if you're gonna take 1% of 314 minutes?
Guys, say your goodbyes. This is Stavros Bus. You can catch me at Stavros Bus on all social media. Guys, you want to say your socials before we leave?
Simple Simon. Simple Simon's doing up Facebook, so Facebook is there. Simple Simon FB for Twitter. I'm not on the gram. You'll never see my face. Those are the only socials at the moment. I'm about, man. Hit me up. It's nothing. Send me questions and stuff and all the rest of it. Need me to elaborate on something, hit me up.
This is Mr. Wolf in a place. I am not on anything regarding Mr. Wolf. Maybe I should do. But you can catch me on Facebook as Yemi. It's Yemi Online on Twitter. And it's Yemi's Insta, I believe. I can't remember, but I'm online. You can find me through the other guys as well.
Catch me on Twitter at Big Wahala. I ain't on Insta. Probably at one point go on Insta. I don't know what for to do. I don't think my face is ready for the world yet.
I think
you've got a face for radio, and
you're a fool.
You've got a face for Snapchat.
Snapchat?
That's you.
Am I 12?
Really? I can see you doing it.
Man, so am I 12?
Snapchat, you know. The only reason for that's people what I thought, Snapchat, you know, is to do nonsense or to sell pussy. That's the only reason why people are on
I
Snapchat.
Thought that Snapchat was a childish thing, pussy. But I tell you, there's a lot of grown man and woman using Snapchat.
I don't know what they're doing.
And they're not
on
from the
I don't know what they're doing on Snapchat. They need to stop being on Snapchat. Every minute on Snapchat.
Just keep us in that alphabet.
Just spare letters.
Anyway, I'm at Big Wahala on Twitter. 5 minutes. Hola. I'm quite active there.
What's good? It's your boy, the Black Parker from Sunrise. I can't even remember. So don't worry about it, man. ESNpodcast.com. Just follow us, man. Simple. By the way, the film that we were talking about with the Pharrell is called Hidden Figures.
That's the one. And I think people should go and watch it because it's got a all black woman cast. Well, not all black woman cast, but
Taraji P. Henson.
And don't be all lecherous when you go in there as well.
Taraji P. Henson's in that, right?
Janelle Monáe.
Oh, and she is a beautiful woman.
Octavia Spence.
Is she not?
Janelle Monáe. Yeah, she's a good meat.
Is she gay?
Who?
Janelle
Monáe.
I don't know.
She's queer.
I hope to God she's not.
All right, ladies and gents. Also, if you want to follow us, you can do that. You can log on to our website. That's www.esnpodcast.com. You can catch us on all the social media links at ESN Podcast and Facebook.
Facebook
is at ESN Podcast, plural with an S. Because like I said last week, somebody's already got the one without the S. So on Facebook, it's at ESN Podcasts. And everywhere else is at ESN Podcast. So link us on Twitter, on Insta, on Snapchat.
Some proper hater
person with a dry pod. No, they have a podcast.
Why does he?
The ESN just stands for something else. It doesn't stand for Eloquently Saying Nothing. Also, you can catch us on iTunes and Stitcher and TuneIn and on Amazon Echo if you can get it to work, because I can't get it to work.
SoundCloud.
On our SoundCloud.
FM.
We are about people.
Yeah, so we're on many, many podcatchers now. So what I want you to do is, whichever one you use, please go there, subscribe, rate, give us a good rating, and also review, tell us what you think, what you'd like us to improve on, if there is anything that can be improved on. You know, if you don't want to be called good meat over the line, you know, that's fine. We might stop. We'll see how it goes. So,
And Mr. Wolf loves the wives and girlfriends.
Speaking of good meat, Janet Jackson had a baby.
Oh, yeah.
We'll talk about that next time.
Yeah, probably. At the age of 50, she had a baby.
Just make sure, please, 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 if you can, make sure you send through anything that you want to discuss to those social medias that Big Stab has already sent through. That'll be great.
Yeah. Thank you for listening. Bye.
Remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you ain't saying nothing, say it well. What the?
Why is that trying to continue on when...